Hello friends, I am Dr. G. Parthsarathy, Senior Consultant Surgical Gastroenterology and Minimal Access Surgery at KIMS Hospital, Minister Road, Secunderabad. Today we will talk about a slightly less common problem, but a problem which we see very frequently in our gastroenterology practice, a problem called achalasia cardia. So what is achalasia cardia? Achalasia is a disease wherein the food pipe slowly gets paralyzed. So normally when we eat, the food is passed from the throat to the stomach through the food pipe or the esophagus. The esophagus is not like a PVC pipe where you drop food in the top and then the food goes down. It doesn't happen like that. The food pipe has to actively push or pump the food down so that it reaches from the throat to the stomach. This requires the esophageal muscles to contract, whereby the food is propelled down. Achalasia is a problem wherein, due to the destruction of the nerves which supply these muscles, the muscles become weaker. So the food pipe is not able to actively propel the food down from the throat to the stomach. Not only does the pushing power of the food pipe come down, also the lower part of the food pipe, where we usually have a valve or a sphincter which controls one-way movement of food from top to bottom and not allowing contents from the stomach back into the chest, that also becomes tight. So a combination of poor pushing power from above plus a tighter valve which increases the resistance of the food to go down creates a disease called achalasia cardia. So why does achalasia cardia happen? Achalasia is a problem whose etiology or the cause is not clearly known. We do not know for sure why some people develop it. Around 1 in a lakh develops this problem. We do not know why that person develops it. But what we know is this is a progressive problem, meaning the weakening of the esophagus starts and keeps on worsening more and more and more as the number of years pass. There is no way that it can be reversed. When do you suspect that somebody has got or might have achalasia cardia? The most common symptom which a patient with achalasia presents is inability to eat food or swallow. The usual complaint is, I take a long time to swallow my food. If three or four of us sit to eat, I am the last one to finish, and it is getting more and more difficult for the food to enter into the stomach. I feel that all the food is locked up in my chest. The second symptom, because there is a lot of food which gets stagnant in the chest and it cannot go down into the stomach, they start getting what is called regurgitation, where after a meal, when they bend down, the food which is filled up to the throat, it comes out through their mouth or nose. They also get foul smelling burps because the food which is pent up here can get fermented and cause a burning feeling and foul smelling burping. This usually is a very gradual process. So the patient slowly realizes that his eating time is getting prolonged more and more over the number of years. Because of poor nutrition, they start losing weight, and then the family members start noticing this. And usually when they present to the doctor for evaluation, it is usually in an advanced state. So whenever a patient presents with these symptoms, we suspect achalasia cardia, and a simple test which can tell us whether the patient has got achalasia or not is called a barium test, where a white colored paste or a barium paste is given to the patient. The patient is made to swallow that and an x-ray is taken. So that will show what is the status of the food pipe. Normally it is a very rigid cylindrical tube. In achalasia, because of constant lower obstruction and the loss of tone, it becomes like a very distended cycle tube. Once we know that this patient has got achalasia, we need to do further advanced test to confirm the diagnosis, and that is done with the help of a esophageal manometry, where it exactly studies the pressure waves in the food pipe, it exactly studies the tightness of the lower valve, and gives a confirmed diagnosis of achalasia. It can also find out what type of the disease. There are multiple types of achalasia. It can also tell us about that. There are many ways to treat achalasia. There are ways where you do only medical treatment, then you can do an endoscopic treatment for achalasia, or you can do a surgical treatment for achalasia. So among these options, pure medicines alone do not give much relief. Coming to the endoscopic therapy, there are ways where the lower valve can be made wider by passing an endoscope, putting a balloon into the valve and distending the balloon, and thereby the valve is opened out and the food passage becomes easier. But the problem with this is the chance of the valve again closing back is very high. So usually they have a temporary relief for some time, and many patients come back with the same symptoms after some time. Then there is a laparoscopic option where, with the help of laparoscopic surgery, without making any cut on the tummy, with the help of small keyholes, the lower valve is released. The ring of it's like a set of bangles in the hand. The bangles are cut. So the lower sphincter, the ring of muscles there are cut with the help of a laparoscope, and thereby the ring is opened and the resistance to food flow is decreased. Of late, a much more advanced technique called POEM, where this entire operation, which was done through laparoscopy, is being done with the help of endoscopy, wherein the lower valve muscles are cut with an advanced endoscopic technique and the food passage is made easier. So once this operation is done, the patient becomes symptom free, their eating capacity improves, and they can get back to their normal eating habits for a prolonged period of time.